Hey there, Gavin Gear here from the Extreme Windows blog, and I'm here at the Oculus VR booth at CES 2014 with Oculus VR VP of Product, Nate Mitchell. Nate, thank you very much for taking the time to talk with me.
Absolutely, thank you guys for coming.
So, CES 2013, you guys had the duct tape prototype, the very early days of the whole program, and now here we are, we've got the dev kit that's been available. You guys showed the HD prototype, which I saw at PAX, and now it's Crystal Cove. Tell me a little bit about Crystal Cove. What's the new magic technology that you guys have put into this system?
Absolutely. So Crystal Cove is the new feature prototype we're showing here at CES 2014. It features really two key breakthroughs that we've been really excited about for a long time. The first is positional tracking, and the second being low persistence. Mm-hmm. So I'll talk a little bit about each of them. So positional tracking actually adds three extra degrees of freedom to the experience. It's something we've talked about a lot, the importance of having positional tracking for the consumer Rift. The original Rift dev kit, we tracked the orientation of your head very, very precisely in real time. Mm-hmm. But if you leaned forward, if you tried to like peek around a corner, for instance, we weren't able to track that data. So that really breaks the immersion and sort of takes away from the experience. Mm-hmm. So there's a big key missing piece. Mm-hmm. So what we've done with Crystal Cove is we actually have an external camera tracking IR LEDs on the headset, and it allows the user to actually move a lot more freely in space. You can lean forward, you can lean back, you can actually stand up, although we don't want you to stand up too much. You can crouch down and look underneath things. So it really opens up a lot of new gameplay possibilities. Mm-hmm. It makes for a more accurate tracking experience, and at the end of the day, it makes the whole thing a lot more comfortable, right? Because it's more accurately reflecting your real-world movements in the virtual space.
So it's not just the model of a camera on a tripod.
Exactly. Yeah. You're not a stick, or a head on a stick, right? Right. Now you can finally actually lean forward, look down, and it's a lot more fun.
So tell me about the display enhancements. If you can, I have the dev kit, the original dev kit. Talk to me about how the HD prototype and Crystal Cove are different and better.
Sure. So with the HD prototype, like you said, we showed at E3. That was a 1080p LCD panel. We were excited about that, sort of give people a glimpse of what we call HD VR. Mm-hmm. Here, in the Crystal Cove prototype, we're actually using an OLED 1080p panel. Wow. Very exciting. When you talk about motion to photons latency, which we talk about quite a bit, which is basically the duration between moving your head or moving any part of your body, whether you're leaning forward or something else, until the correct image reaches your eye, right?
Gotcha.
That's sort of where the magic of VR happens. It's like how minimal can we make that time so that you really do feel like everything is happening in real time, just like real life.
Yeah.
So pixel switching time has constantly been a key challenge there. With LCD technology, you on average have between a 15 to 30, maybe 40 millisecond pixel switching time, which means that we write the right image to the display, but then we actually have to wait for all the pixels to change color.
Yeah.
And so that really causes this huge delay between, hey, this is now the new image being sent, but it doesn't get there for a long time. And your brain is very sensitive to this stuff, right? We look around all the time, basically zero latency, your eye tracking, the way you perceive the world. Mm-hmm. So it's super important to get that right. With Crystal Cove OLED, we have a sub-millisecond pixel switching time. That makes a huge amount of difference. You're still left with judder, but using the magic of low persistence, we're able to eliminate motion blur and judder. That's really the key takeaway. So in the original Oculus kit, you move, there's a lot of motion blur. It makes it very, very hard to read text, especially because you look at something, and it's very unnatural to lock your head into position, right? You're always moving a tiny bit, and that means all that text is always smearing. The whole image is smearing.
Right.
So with low persistence, it makes the whole world significantly more visually stable. And again, that really increases the comfort level. It's a breakthrough. It doesn't sound, as exciting necessarily as like positional tracking. You're like, huh, new display technology, okay. But it really levels up the whole experience pretty substantially. And it's one of the things we're most excited about.
Well, then you have the aspect of the increased resolution, right?
Absolutely.
Because if you have split 720, it gives you a preview into the experience, but you can't really read a heads-up display. You can't see the gauges, on the dashboard.
It limits the amount of virtual reality that you can actually achieve, right? Because you're like, oh, there's some text, but I can't read it. Not so good.
Yeah, right.
So it really does, again, make it a lot more fun. That's a really key goal, right? Is we want to maximize immersion, we want to maximize fun, comfort, and all those things together, that's where you get the magic of VR, the holodeck experience that we really want to deliver with the consumer V1.
Yeah. So I've seen the HD prototype. I was really blown away by the sort of extension of the experience.
Right.
I'm really looking forward to seeing Crystal Cove to see that taken actually to the next level. But before we do that, tell me a little bit about the game partners that you're working with and how they're going to take advantage of the new sort of more low latency, the increased positional tracking capabilities, that kind of thing.
So I can't go too much into the details of specific companies. You know, we've seen a huge amount of indie content developed for the consumer Rift, or at least on the dev kits that are out there now. We've seen a lot of excitement from big guys like Valve, like Epic, Unity, the team at CCP. One of the main demos we're showing here today is actually Valkyrie, which is a made-for-VR experience being developed by the same guys who've done EVE Online and Dust 514. At the end of the day, to your original question, we haven't... The Crystal Cove prototypes, this is the first time we're showing them, so no devs have access to them yet, or not too many devs, but we're going to be, you know, rolling these features into the consumer version. That's a really key point, is that positional tracking and low persistence will be part of the consumer Rift. So as devs get their hands on new hardware, some point, that features these things, they'll be able to do totally new experiences that would have been impossible without positional tracking and low persistence, just like we've been talking about.
I can't wait to experience that, right? And for that to become mainstream.
Me too.
I know there might not be a whole lot you can tell me about this, but dev kits and consumer hardware.
Yes.
When are we going to see it and what are we going to see?
So unfortunately, we haven't announced a release date yet for the consumer version. It's really important. You know, VR is one of those things where you really need to get it right. And we're building this, something really special with the Rift. And when we have all of those pieces aligned, you do get that magic sense of presence, like, wow, I'm really someplace else. So with new dev hardware, we've talked a lot about potentially the need for a second development kit near the consumer version, so that if you're a developer, if we're making a game together, we can actually test on